Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. I'm Claire. I'm working as a research assistant in Branka Horvat's lab in the CEA Institute. I will present here a short summary of a project ongoing in our lab for the last few years. This work has been done with a public-private consortium with DTF Medical in Saint-Étienne, the CPR in Tours, and the Columbia University in New York. The aim of this project is to develop a system of airway protection against Nipah virus, using antiviral peptides delivered by inhalation. So first of all, here are a few important points about Nipah virus. It's an emergent virus discovered in Malaysia in 1998. The reservoir of the virus is a fruit bat located mainly in Southeast Asia, Australia, and in Africa. This virus is zoonotic and is able to infect a broad range of mammal species. It's capable of interhuman transmission and causes acute respiratory distress and encephalitis with a high fatality rate from 70 to 100%. There are epidemics nearly annually in Asia with big consequences for the health system and economy of the country. The current lack of vaccines or treatment against Nipah virus infection justify the development of new antiviral approach. And the target of our approach is a fusion protein present at the surface of the virus. It's a preventive approach based on antiviral peptides delivered by inhalation. Several peptides developed by the Columbia University were tested in our lab in vitro. The peptide shown here was selected for its capacity to inhibit the virus fusion machinery and block its entry into host cells. We would like to deliver it by nebulization to cover the major part of the entry route of the virus. Our results being very promising in vitro, we verified our hypothesis in vivo. The protection efficacy of the peptide was shown with a dose of 10 milligrams per kilo delivered in intranasal in a Syrian golden hamster model, very susceptible to Nipah infection with 100% of lethality, 13 days post-infection. 50% of survival was shown for treated hamster. Now, before transposing this approach in human clinical assays, the proof of concepts need to be verified in a non-human primate model. The African green monkey, or AGM, is the most relevant large model to mimic human Nipah infection and is suitable to use the same inhalation device as human. A previous experiment done in the biosafety level 4 laboratory of Lyon has shown 100% of lethality 10 days post-infection in Nipah-infected AGM, using only 100 viral particles. And these animals showed symptoms matching with the pathogenesis observed in humans. The nebulizer and its interface to use with AGM was developed by DTF Medical and tested for its in vitro performances by the CPR aerosol team. Aerosols produced by the nebulizer are matching standard lung deposition requirements with a droplet volume median diameter of 4 micrometer and up to 70% of fine particle fraction. Here, the peptide was collected after nebulization and it was tested for its viral fusion inhibition capacity. Up to 97% of functionality remains, which confirmed the possibility to use this customized mesh nebulizer for peptide aerosolization. Inhalation with the nebulizer system was reproduced in vitro, connecting an AGM nasal cast model with a respiratory pump. Aerosol distribution was measured with ventilation and showed 50% of deposition into the respiratory tract with a high 40% prediction for lung targeting. Then, in vivo, the lung deposition was measured by gamma scintigraphy in 3 macaques. Inhalation of 3 ml of a radioactive tracer with a nebulization system showed 8 to 16% of aerosol deposition in the lung. This confirms the adequation of the nebulization system for lung treatment delivery and validates its use for our study in AGM. Before to validate the protective efficacy of the peptide, it was necessary to evaluate its biodistribution and its toxicity after inhalation. This assay was done in 2 steps. In the first phase, all monkeys were nebulized at day 0 with a unique dose. In the secondary phase, all monkeys were nebulized with several doses at day 0, 1, and 2. One animal control received a physiological serum and 3 others received the peptide at 4 milligrams per kilo. in a volume of 3 ml. Blood and urine samples were taken regularly and all animals were sacrificed at the end for organ collection. The results of this experiment were very satisfying. No deleterious variation was observed in food consumption, weight or rectal temperature, and clinical scores remained low during the whole experiment. No adverse events were due to inhalation comparing treated animals to controls, and the hematological, biochemical and urinary parameters did not show variations that were deleterious for the animals. No peptides were found by ELISA in sera and urine, and immunofluorescence assays using peptide-specific antibodies on organ slices revealed the presence of peptides along the respiratory tract 24 hours after administration. The image of immunofluorescence, where we can see the peptide in red. The peptide is mainly localized in the alveoli and the epithelial area of both lungs. Our peptide and nebulizer are now ready for the first study with the infectious Nipah virus in the BSL-4, in the BSL-4 view. This experiment will be done with AGMs nebulized with several consecutive doses of peptide and if intratracheal route with Nipah. A new system of telemetry will allow us to follow precisely the respiratory frequency of the animals and detect any first symptoms of infection. Unfortunately, with the COVID context, this experiment was delayed and we are still waiting to know when the monkeys could be transported to France. But a success of this experiment may provide in the future a protection for people against Nipah infection. This study may open new perspectives for antiviral prevention against other respiratory viruses using the same system of cell entry. And also this strategy could be further extended to the ongoing SARS-CoV-2 outbreak. Antifusion peptides are already in development for this purpose in our team. I would like to thank my team and to acknowledge our collaborators for the work done on this project. And thank you to the audience for your attention.
Claire, thanks very much for that talk. An even scarier virus than coronavirus, by the sound of it.
Yes.
Can I ask, would you need to give the peptide preventatively?
Sorry.
Would you need to give the peptide preventatively? Would you need to give it before exposure to the virus
to? The actual peptide we are using would be more for preventive treatment, but we are trying to develop a modified peptide that could eventually be used also as a treatment after infection.
Mm-hmm. And if it was preventative, do you think it would need daily dosing?
So for now, we know the half-life of the peptide would be 24 hours, so I would say yes, before treatment in a daily dose.
Okay. And a final question. Would it be important to get both nasal and lung deposition? Do you need to cover both regions of the respiratory tract to prevent viral transmission?
Yes, that would be the best because the virus is able to propagate quickly in the lungs and also through the nasal tract. It can go to the brain, and that's why there is also encephalitis. And that would be better if the whole respiratory tract is completely covered by the peptide to protect.
Okay. Thank you very much. Best of luck, both for yourself and for all of us.
Thank you.
Thank you.